It's the other one that interests me. Susie Driscoll. Find out anything you can about her.
Susie? What the hell?
Susie, is that who you're looking for?
No, I think I got the wrong address.
I don't think so. Now, what's your association with Donna Mason?
Please, somebody help me. No.
Hope you don't behave like that in front of your sister-in-law. After all she's done for you. Oh, I hope the court doesn't get to hear about this little episode. They might not think you're a fit mother. And of course, there are lots of things that I'd be only too willing to tell the court. So clean this up!
Oh, I intend to.
Slut. I warned you, Latham. I warned you! Where are you? We'll try that again in a hurry, will you?
Please, stop!
Oh. God damn you, Latham! You made me lose my temper!
This is Judy Bryant, Inspector. She'd done time for drug trafficking, prostitution, assault and theft.
I was clear to that one.
Assaulting a police officer.
And you've managed to escape more than once, haven't you, Bryant?
Yeah, but I'm out this time legally.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't use that term too loosely if I was you. Sit down. Tell me how you're managing to make a living now that you're legally on the outside.
Hmm? You haven't been doing your homework, Inspector.
Yeah, well, I've heard that you've been working the streets dealing in drugs.
You've worked all of that out because I was at Donna Mason's, right?
Well, what's your connection with her?
There's no connection. I was just there on business.
Drug business?
You know me better than that.
Yeah? Judy Bryant served a 2-year sentence at Wentworth Detention Centre for possession of marijuana.
Yes, and you know why, so don't give me that bull. It's all there in the report.
Well, I'll rephrase the question then. What's your connection with Donna Mason?
There is no connection. I don't even know her. I was just there because I was looking for a kid called Susie Driscoll.
Yeah, well, you're not the only one.
Are you looking for her too?
Yes, we are, Miss Bryant. And perhaps you can help us.
If I knew where she was, I wouldn't be out looking for her, would I? All right. I was trying to find Susie to take her back to my place. I run a halfway house for Wentworth.
Yeah, I know. 32 Worthington Street. It's on our surveillance list.
Yeah, I'll bet it is. Listen, what do you want her for?
Well, let's just say she could be useful to us. Now, you can go now, Bryant. But you see Susie Driscoll and you let me know straight away, all right?
Lovey maker. She's nothing but a troublemaker. Can't be trusted to do a damn thing. That's why she hasn't got a friend in the world.
All right, what's your excuse this time, Latham?
God. What have you done to her? I told you. She got out of control. But she attacked me.
I'm going to get the sister as soon as possible.
Help me get her up.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Davidson, but I'm afraid we've got trouble. Chrissie Latham's attacked one of the officers.
Who?
Joan Ferguson.
Oh, no. Is Miss Ferguson all right?
She's got a bump in her head. Apart from that, she's fine.
Well, Latham's really done it this time. Did anyone witness what happened?
No. Look, I think you should see Latham before you form any opinion. She's in the infirmary.
The infirmary?
Yes. She's been very badly beaten.
Oh. And why the frown? You've decided a decent day's work doesn't suit you after all.
I'm just wondering who gets into the cells while we're all safely occupied. Ours is a mess.
What do you mean?
Well, looks like there's been a brawl in there or a party or something.
Could be either. You asked your little cellmate.
Yeah, what if I could find her?
Well, well. Looks like our little Miss Latham has had another one of her tantrums and ended up in the pound. Do you want one of the girls to give you a hand clean up that mess?
No, it's all right. I'll do it myself. I know everything goes.
Yeah, I'll do it before the freak sees it. And what's wrong with you, as if I didn't know?
I feel sick. I need some help.
And whose fault's that?
And I don't need a bloody lecture. I just need something, please.
Hey, anyone help? We need help here in Mason's cell. Not that I like your chances. The screws are not going to be too sympathetic. But then again, maybe this time you could be lucky.
What's going on? The new kid's not too good. What's the matter, Mason?
She's in for prostitution. And the obvious? I think the obvious is giving her trouble.
You know the girl that Susie got mixed up with, aren't you?
That's right, Susie's friend.
I need a doctor or someone or not!
You stay with her, B. I'll get Sister Franklin.
Oh, oh my God.
Oh. We won't keep you long, Latham. We just want to find out what happened this afternoon.
I bloody will tell you and all. Ferguson tried to kill me.
We're only interested in the facts. And the fact is that you attempted to strike an officer.
Look, you lot, you don't know what she's like. She went too far. I just couldn't stand it anymore.
Well, surely you couldn't expect to get away with it.
I didn't expect nothing. I never even planned it. When she hit the door, I thought I'd wiped her out. I wish I had.
So you do admit to hitting her. What happened then?
See for yourself.
Did you try to defend yourself?
You've got to be kidding. What chance did I have against her? What are you going to do about it, Mrs. Davidson?
Nothing until I find out the truth.
That chance you got of that with her.
Oh, now, come on. Your record isn't glowing with honesty.
You just got to look at me to see what happened.
We'll need to talk to you again after I've had Officer Ferguson's report.
You're not going to let her get away with this.
Talk to you later.
She's bloody well going to suffer for what she's done to me. And if you don't do nothing about it, I will.
Well, what do you think?
I think it's the most disgusting thing I've had to deal with in this place, and I shall do everything in my power to get to the bottom of it. Thank you. I see what you meant about checking on Latham's condition before making any judgments. Does Joan Ferguson really expect us to believe it was self-defense?
Well, I doubt that she had to go to those lengths to get Latham under control.
Of course she didn't. I'll have to ring Mr. Douglas straight away. I want you to hear that story of Latham's.
Right. Now, what are we going to do about Joan? Are we going to leave her on duty?
For the time being, but keep a very close eye on her, will you?
Oh, yes, I will.
Judy, is there anything wrong?
I think I've blown everything.
What do you mean?
I've just had the third degree from the cops.
Why? You're not in trouble, are you?
No, but I think Susie Driscoll is. I went over to Donna Mason's flat to see if I could find her.
How do you know where she is? I mean, I've only just found out the address myself.
Well, it doesn't matter. I got the address anyway. When I got there, the police were there. They must have thought I was involved in Donna's drug racket or something. They dragged me into the police station and questioned me. When I told them I was only looking for Susie Driscoll, they said they were too. And I got to get to her and find her. You know what Inspector Grace is like.
Judy, look, please understand me. I'm not interfering. But if you want my advice...
I want your help. Please... Couldn't you go to Donna and ask her where Susie is? Then maybe I can get to her first. I mean, they're going to throw the book at her.
All right, I'll see what I can arrange. Now you go back to the house and see if Susie arrives. If she does, promise me you'll ring Inspector Grace back.
Yeah, all right.
Who let you in here? Oh, sister.
Save your breath. She's on a break.
You better not touch me again. I've told Dave everything.
Oh, that's a pity. Because it's only your word against mine. And you've already earned yourself quite a reputation for telling tales, haven't you?
But I know I'm not lying this time. Look at me. I didn't do this to myself, did I?
Then you'll just have to change your story. The women have had it in for you for a long time. Everyone knows that. And anything could have happened after I left the cell. Couldn't it? So you're going to have to soft pedal this issue, because I can make things very painful for you, and not just physically. Well, it all depends how much you want that kid of yours. And then there's the question of me appearing to discredit you as a mother.
Oh, you bloody bitch.
Just tell the truth.
Which is?
That you fought to the end and I had to defend myself.
That's crap.
I hope I don't have to pay another visit.
What are you doing in this area?
I wanted to see how Latham is.
Yes, well, I would forget about her if I were you, at least until her injuries have been explained.
It wasn't easy getting her under control. You know what she's like. She doesn't give in quickly. She'll tell you that herself if you can get her to admit it.
I'll be speaking to her when she's up to it. Now, meanwhile, I'd suggest you submit your own report to Mrs. Davidson on the incident.
Tell me, Mrs. Powell, have you ever been threatened by a prisoner?
Of course. But I've never found it necessary to go as far as you did. Mr. Douglas is waiting with Mrs. Davidson. He may wish to discuss this with you.
Oh, is it that time already?
Already?
It's been the longest day of my life.
Any more news about Chrissie?
No. I tried speaking to her, but she wasn't up to it. I don't know. It worries me, Meg. We can't have this sort of thing happening.
I just can't believe Joan would be so stupid.
Afternoon, ladies.
Oh, good afternoon, Inspector Grace. What can we do for you?
I want to speak to Donna Mason.
I was trying to contact you earlier, actually. I believe you're looking for Susie Driscoll.
Yes, but not now, Mrs. Morris. I'm in a hurry.
Okay, I'll get Mason.
Thanks. You know we had Susie in here with us for a while.
Yes, I do. The way she's going, it won't be long before she's back again.
Yeah, come on, when do we eat? We're all present and correct, so what's the hold-up?
Hey, wait a minute, where's Chrissie?
Latham won't be joining you for the evening meal.
Oh, we must have left her off the invitation list by mistake.
Okay, but quiet.
I don't feel well. Can I see the sister?
No.
Mrs. Powell, I want to see the sister because I feel sick.
I've already told you no, Mason.
The sister isn't on duty, but if you're not well, you can see her in the morning. Let the women through to the dining room, please, Miss Ferguson. All except Mason. She's got a visitor.
All right, you lot, don't push. None of you look as if you're starving to death.
She was only sent here as a last resort. I mean, she hasn't got a criminal record or anything.
Yeah, okay, Mrs. Morris. Now, look, when do I see Mason? I am in a hurry.
Look, they won't be long. Susie's very young and naive. She could have got mixed up with the wrong crowd. I mean, she might need help.
Mrs. Morris, I'm a copper. I'm not interested in juvenile rehabilitation. Now, if little Susie can help me get some bigger fish, like the pushers or the dealers, well, then I'll give her all the help she needs. If not, she's history as far as I'm concerned. If I worried about every little mole that ca... Good. Now, where can I see Mason?
You can't. She refuses to speak to you.
Well, she doesn't know where Susie is. I've already spoken to her.
Well, we mustn't upset the ladies, must we, Mrs. Morris? Let me know if she changes her mind, will you?
What'd you find out?
From him? Absolutely nothing. Honestly, one session with him
and I'm beginning to understand the women's attitude towards the police.
Don't let him upset you. It's just the way it works.
Thought you were going home.
Oh, so did I. Joan Barfield's sick. I'll have to hang around. Serves me right, huh?
Here, I'll get it for you. Thanks. Hey, I wouldn't do anything to hurt Susie. I was just sick and I needed help, Hannah, because I was really sick and I wouldn't hurt her, honest, I wouldn't.
Well, I never met her, so I don't know.
Listen, one thing. Stop talking about your habit in here. Dope is real bad news, and you may have noticed that B doesn't like it.
Come on, Dory, hurry up. When you've finished your meal, I want you to go down to the kitchen and get a tray and take it up to the hospital.
Okay, but who's sick?
Never mind. Just report to me when you're finished.
London to a brick at Chrissie Latham, eh, Mrs. Morris? Ho ho. The plot thickens.
What do you reckon's going on, B?
Well, we won't know until you get up there and find out, will we? You better hurry up and eat.
Everybody's always telling me what to do. Bloody hell, what happened to you?
Let's just say I had a freak accident.
The freak?
Put the tray down, please, Doreen. Mr. Douglas will see you as soon as you've finished your lunch.
Right, yeah, what gives?
Pal B, you should see Chrissie. It looks as though somebody's been using her for a footy.
Ah, so she did get into a brawl.
Yeah, well, she couldn't say very much because Mrs. Morris was there all the time. But something's up.
Well, it could have been anyone. Chrissie didn't exactly make inmate of the month.
Yeah, well, she said that she'd had a freak accident.
Oh, what? Don't tell me she'd be stupid enough to take on Ferguson.
She mightn't have had any say in it.
But Ferguson wouldn't leave her looking like that. The department would have her out in her ear.
In that case, I hope it is her. Maybe she won't get away with it.
Yeah, and better it happened to Chrissie than any one of us.
Well, fair enough. But that doesn't alter the fact we've got a bad screw on our hands. And just think, next time it'll be one of you.
How are you feeling now, Chrissie?
I'll live.
I'd like you to tell Mr. Douglas exactly what you told us earlier.
I've already spoken to Miss Ferguson, Latham, so stay as close to the truth as you can.
I lost control. I attacked Miss Ferguson.
Go on.
Well, I thought I'd knocked her out at first, but I hadn't, so I had another go. Well, I had to, didn't I? I mean, she would have clobbered me.
Is this what you brought me to hear? It's not the first time an officer's been attacked, you know?
Is that all you have to say, Chrissie?
Yeah, that's it. Oh, yeah. It won't happen again. And I'm sorry.
Yes.
I really don't see why you called me on this one, Erica.
You don't really believe she's telling the truth, do you?
Well, we can only ask what happened, and according to Latham, Miss Ferguson was telling the truth.
And what about her injuries?
Oh, for God's sake, the woman attacked an officer.
Chrissie Latham has cracked ribs, contusions, a split lip, and a black eye. Miss Ferguson has a bump on the head. I want to know what I'm to do about it.
Nothing.
You can't be serious.
Very much so. As I see it, Miss Ferguson had no option but to defend herself.
I see. Of course, the minister wouldn't like the scandal, would he? Not to mention the officers might go on strike if we took action against a union member.
I do you have something else to do, Mrs. Parr?
Of course.
All right, Erica, what is it you want?
I want more information on Joan Ferguson's service in Queensland.
You've seen her record.
Records have been known to be whitewashed, both prisoners and officers.
Why are you making such an issue of this? Miss Ferguson was totally justified in defending herself. I think you just should forget the whole thing. Now, obviously, Latham is prepared to.
She wasn't before you arrived. Something is wrong, Ted, and I want to know what it is. Yes? These reports on the Chrissie Latham incident need clarification.
Oh, in what way, Governor?
Your report states that the prisoner attacked you from behind and you had to subdue her.
Yes, that's what happened.
Miss Ferguson, if you merely subdued her, how do you account for the extent of her injuries?
Well, I agree that was unfortunate, but Latham was in a rage. I acted accordingly.
Mrs. Powell's report does not substantiate that.
Mrs. Powell wasn't there.
Why do you think Latham attacked you?
Fear of losing her daughter, I imagine.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm only surmising, but it's the only explanation I can think of. Latham's sister-in-law had asked me to give character evidence against her.
In a custody battle over the child?
Yes. Oh, I wasn't going to do it, of course. I don't believe that we should interfere in their private affairs.
But you suspect that Latham thought that you were?
Well, that's the only reason I could think of. Why else would she attack me?
That is what we are trying to find out. Why didn't you mention this before?
Well, it all happened so quickly, Governor, I haven't had time to think.
Did she say anything to that effect?
No, not a thing. In fact, I thought she'd gone mad. She certainly looked it when she went for me.
Perhaps other pressures were put upon her.
I suppose Mr. Douglas will want to see me again?
No, I don't think so. That will be all, thank you, Miss Ferguson.
Come on, get down.
Oh, I can't make it, honest. I'm not kidding you. It's me kneecaps.
Oh, it was your back a minute ago.
Yeah, well, I buggered me knees too. Came off me bike doing 80.
Oh, good. Well, get out of the van about the same speed now.
Yeah, but what about me back?
Oh, Daniels, for heaven's sakes, get out.
Yeah, well, I got whiplash in the ambulance on the way to the hospital. Bloody driver drove up the arse of a van. Stupid
get
bugger.
Get out of very
much. Oh, me ribs. Oh, God. Oh, crikey, you've really done it now, haven't you?
Oh, it's your ribs too, eh?
Yeah, bloody cops took me down to the watch house and tore into me. Yeah, but they'll get theirs because I got their numbers.
Anything wrong, Mrs. Berry?
Just about everything by the sound of it.
Oh, it's a hold-up.
Yeah, Mrs. Berry. What's the hold-up? I reckon I could have been a sunstroke hanging around out here.
Daniels, that explains it.
Oh, you know her, do you?
Mm-hmm. She's a liar, a sneak, a loafer, and a hypochondriac. Get inside.
Sure, Miss Ferguson.
Must have been the way I said it.
Your brother's here.
Oh.
Well.
Well? Well, what? What happened to Hello Sis? How are you?
I can see how you are. You're a bleating mess, aren't you? What are you doing in here again, eh? That's what I want to know.
Mr. Faulkner, I'm in terrible pain. I've been trying to call the sister, but there's no...
She's over at maternity.
Please, can you get her for me? I can hardly breathe.
Well, aren't you going to help her? I'll see what I can do.
Oh, I'll talk to you.
Hey, look, you just can't keep out of it, can you?
Please,
Del. I'll go away for a few weeks, and when I get back, what do I find, eh? Elizabeth's been kidnapped, you're over on a fraud charge and attempted escape. What's the matter with you?
I needed the money. I needed it for Elizabeth. Please, Brenda, she's going to take her away.
Yeah, well, you're seeing to that yourself, aren't you?
She's going to take her away from me for good. She's got this screw and she's going to testify against me.
Yeah. She told me about that. Someone called Ferguson.
Yeah. It's the bloody bitch who bashed me up.
What? An officer did that?
Yeah. She said it was self-defense. Just doing her job, she said. She nearly killed me. She did her job so well.
But what goes on in this place, eh?
That's why I can't buck at this girl. I've just got to take it, can't you see that? That bitch, she's going to paint me so black I'll never see Elizabeth again.
Hey.
Oh, girl. I know I've done wrong, but I can't bear it without Elizabeth. Please.
Don't worry about it. It'll be all right. I'll see to it.
Brenda, she's going to get her. I know it. She's got everything going for her. Please, girl. Please help me.
Oh, miss, and don't even ask. You've had enough tranquilizers to bring down an elephant.
No, it's not that. It's just that, I felt I've got the right to make a phone call, and I want to call my brother because he hasn't even been in to see me.
Oh, yes, that's all right.
Thanks.
Come on, come with me.
Yeah?
It's me, Donna.
How are you making out?
How do you reckon? I thought you might come in and see me.
Look, I'm pretty busy.
Des, you're all I've got. Please bring me in a present. You know that always makes me happy.
Oh, please, Des, you've got to. You've got to.
Sure, I'll see that you're fixed up. Look, I've got to get to work, okay?
You mean to Susie. It's Susie now, isn't it? Look, please come in and see me, please.
Sweat it out, slut.
What? Well, is your brother coming in?
I know. Oh, I think so, yeah.
Oh, that's good. Come on, let's go.
I'm sorry, but that's all I can do.
Yeah, well, I'm sorry too. Who is this Officer Ferguson?
That's me. What's the problem?
My name's Latham. Derek Latham. And the problem's my sister. I've just seen what you've done to her. You're mad.
I think you'd better sign out, Mr. Latham.
No, I'm not going anywhere until I've seen the governor.
Oh, well, you can't see the governor today. She won't be free.
No? Well, I'll wait until she is free. And then I'm going to find out how come my sister can almost get beaten to death by one of her officers.
Yeah, well, there's a whole mob of us. We came down from up north for a big bikey turn.
So you in here for long?
Can't keep me here. Didn't do nothing, did I? Oh, yeah, I was. Drunk and disorderly. Dangerous driving. Exceeding the speed limit. Oh, yeah. Abusing and assaulting a police officer.
Be out in no time. Sounds like it was a good turn.
Oh, yeah, grouse. Then this bloke. He tries to drag me off with his quacker 750. And I thought, I'll do him. And I had her over the ton. Then he pulls out his badge and tells me to pull over.
Yeah, they can be bastards, all right.
Yeah, well, that's where the abusing and assaulting an officer came in.
What did you do to him?
What do you think? When I was through with him, he was walking all hunched over with his knees together like this. Oh, God!
You're bloody mad.
Yeah, that's right, Granny. Mad Maxine!
It's a pity Bea was transferred to the workshop. She could have done with a good laugh.
Yeah, Bea gets moved and all you bludgers stop work.
Oh, come on, Lizzie, it's all right. We're just having a smoker. Oh, well, I suppose we ought to get back to it.
Hey, Maxine, you want to give me a hand with this? Oh, sorry, mate. Can't. Whiplash came off me bike. You give her a hand, Granny.
I'll give you a bloody hand if you don't stop calling me Granny. She's bloody useless.
Oh, come on, she's good for a laugh.
Oh, watch out for your back, Gran. You don't want a cop whiplash too.
What's wrong?
I thought you were the cops.
Cops don't use keys, sweetheart. They kick. Don't worry. They won't find you up here.
Oh, I hope not. If I go back to Wentworth and Bea finds out I've been on the game, she'll kill me. I can't go back, Des.
You won't. Don't worry. I'll look after you. All you have to do is learn to trust me. I'll soon get you out of this.
Oh.
It's not going to be easy, but I reckon I can swing it. Now, all we have to do is get enough money so that you can get into state, or I can pay off the cops and they'll drop the charges.
Could you do that?
It's going to take a lot of cash, but I've got connections. Well, what do you say?
Well, how will I get that much money?
How do you think?
Well, couldn't I just make a run for it?
Oh, how far do you think you'd get?
But I haven't done anything. Well, not really.
You've been working as a pro. Then there's the dope. That'll get you at least 5 years.
That was Donna's.
Oh, you tried telling the cops that. No, sweetheart, you've only got one choice. Work a few tricks for me so I can pay off the cops, or go back to Wentworth.
But if I go out in the street to get customers, they'll pick me up anyway.
So, stay here and I'll bring the tricks up to you. What do you say?
All right. I don't suppose I've got much choice anyway.
Good girl. Now you get yourself all fixed up and I'll go and drum up some trade. This door stays locked. That way no one can get to you unless they're with me.
Mrs. Davidson?
Yes.
Derek Latham.
Oh, yes, Mr. Latham. Would you like to come into my office?
No, it won't take long. I just want to know what happened to my sister and why.
Well, that is what we're trying to find out. I assure you, the incident is under close review.
Oh, don't give me that rubbish. You know the incident will stay under review until it's forgotten.
It will not be forgotten, Mr. Latham.
Yeah, well, how come Ferguson is still here? And why is she trying to get Chrissie's kid taken away from her?
Miss Ferguson had no intention of interfering in that affair.
Well, you try telling that to my wife. She's got Ferguson's word that she'll appear against Chrissie in court. You really stick together, don't you? Girl, what sort of chance has Chrissie got against you lot?
Mr. Latham. Oh. Oh, I don't think you can really blame him. And he did raise some good points.
Well, that's the trouble when something like this happens. It reflects on all of us.
Here, sweetheart. Have something to eat.
No, I'm not hungry.
Ah, come on, it's good grub. I ran into these blokes from Perth. They're coming up in half an hour. They've got plenty of big money too. They're a bit rough, but they're funny buggers. At least you'll get a laugh out of them.
Oh no, Des, I'm scared and I'm tired. Please, no rough ones, you're bringing too many.
Listen, you're on your back, right? You can rest and work at the same time.
I'm frightened.
Oh, come on, sweetheart. I was only kidding. These blokes are all right. They're just all talk, that's all. The money you're making, you're going to be out of this soon. You made a packet today. Hell, keep this up and you'll be able to retire at 18. And I'll screw these other suckers for 400. All right, I'll slow it down for you. Here, eat that.
The chuck wagon.
Oh, get away. He's nice. When am I going to get somebody back with me in me dorm?
Don't worry, I'll arrange something.
Supposing I got me palpitations and I was all on me pap Malone, who'd know about it?
I'm sure if anything was wrong with you, the whole world would know about it. Go and get your food, would you?
See, I like to move around. Different places, different blokes. That way you don't get bored.
See, like now, I'm bored.
Why don't you try doing some work?
Oh, no, thanks. What else you got in here?
Just the workshop.
Workshop. Nah, don't like the sound of that. What I need is a rest. God. What's the hospital like?
There's nothing the matter with you.
We'll be in a minute. Watch.
Get up, Danny.
Oh, I can't. I've got me back.
some slop spilt gravy all over the floor. I'd do you for this, you know. You'd go. Yes, I can't bloody move. Oh,
well, we better take her to the infirmary for a checkup.
I doubt there's anything wrong with her. Miss Ferguson gave me the lowdown on this one. Apparently she's always pulling this stunt.
Oh, well, boy. Let's make sure, shall we?
Oh, gee, thanks, Mrs. Powell. Oh, God. Oh, come on. You're going to have to help me. I don't mean kneecaps as well. Can't get up by myself.
Oh, really? Won't that hurt your ribs?
Mr. Faulkner, would you just help her?
Oh. Oh. Oh.
Gee, thanks. Hey, I wouldn't mind giving you a ride sometime. Do you like bikes?
Let's go. Oh.
Mad Maxine is right.
Mad? She's mad as a bloody hatter.
That was nice. You're still fresh. You've been with Des long?
I'm not with him. Well, not really.
That'd be news to Des. Tough about Donna.
Did you know her?
I was one of her regulars. I knew her when she first started. She was bloody green when Des found her. But she got into it. Then she got into the smack. Are you on it yet?
No, of course not.
Oh, sure. Give yourself time.
No, I mean it. I'll never touch the stuff. Look, will you help me get out of here? But I'm scared of Des.
What about my neck? No, you're in it, kid. Forget it.
I've got to get away.
Why? Enjoy yourself. Earn lots of money.
Decent.
Don't say anything, please.
Everything okay?
Sure, great. She'll need a bit of breaking in, but apart from that, great.
All right, what's wrong now?
I want to get away.
Oh, I get it. You need a change of scenery. Like Wentworth, maybe.
No.
That's where you'll end up, kid. Look, this deal with the cops is almost lined up. All you need is another 1,000 and you're off the hook.
I can't. I just can't do it anymore. I hate it. I hate it.
Is that all that's worrying you? Well, why didn't you say so before? I can fix it so you won't feel a thing. You'll float through it, sweetheart. And when you come down, you'll be rich. Rich and free.
Like Donna.
Donna's done. You'd just be joy-jabbing to get yourself through this.
I was just nervous, that's all. I'll be all right.
All you need to do is ask. I'll take care of you.
Yeah, well, you know where you made your first mistake, don't you?
Yeah, so just shut up, will you?
Yeah, when you hit that screw, you didn't hit her hard enough. Now you ain't got a chance. She'll ride you, and so will her mates.
She will never do this to me again. Never.
Who's gonna stop her? Once you get it...
Oh, this is Daniels. She came in this morning. Daniels, this is Mrs. Davidson, our governor.
Nice place you got here.
Good. We must see if we can extend your stay. How are you feeling? Any better?
A bit.
Latham, you made it very difficult for us yesterday by refusing to cooperate when Mr. Douglas was here.
I just want to forget all about that.
Well, I don't, and neither does your brother. Why did you change your story? Were you afraid that by talking it might result in the loss of your daughter?
No. We are trying to help you.
If it is the reason, Officer Ferguson has assured me that she will not interfere in the situation.
If my face didn't hurt so much, I could get a laugh out of that, I could.
I don't think you realise how loath the courts are to take a child away from its natural mother.
But I'm not a mother, am I? I'm a bloody crim, ask anyone.
It is also possible that Officer Ferguson's evidence would not now be acceptable.
Derek said that.
So we need to know the truth.
Is it true that you struck first?
Yeah.
And is it true that you received your injuries whilst Officer Ferguson was defending herself?
Well, what do you think? I went down like a bag of... I went down. That didn't stop her, though, did it? Oh, no. She just kept on kicking and kicking and laying into me.
Why?
Because she hates my guts, that's why.
Yes, but what do you mean by that?
She thought Anna Simpson and me were on together. She was always talking about it, always jealous.
Why would she be jealous?
Because she had the hots for Anna herself, didn't she?
All right, Latham, that will be all for now.
You wanted the truth, didn't you?
Yes.
You know, you're playing me favourite game. Screw the screw. And bugger me, it looks like you might have a chance.
Yeah, well, just give it a rest, will you?
Might as well play it. And this one.
Can I see Chrissie?
Mr. Latham, you've already had a visit today.
Yeah, I know, but it's really important.
I'm sorry, she's very upset. She needs a rest. Surely you can understand that.
Well, look, I know what's upsetting her and I've fixed it. I just want to tell her, that's all. Oh, go on, let me see her.
Well, a second visit's going to have to be authorised by the governor.
How? How did you do it?
It was a piece of cake. I told Brenda that I wouldn't support her if she tried to get custody.
Oh, Derek.
I hurt her a bit, but, well, she's just got to wake up to herself. I couldn't let you down again, sis. Anyway, the way it stands now is that I'm going to get custody of Elizabeth, not Brenda. So, you know, she'll be looked after till you get out.
That's no bloody different to what it was before.
Yes, it is. I mean, she's going to be raised as your child.
Derek, do you know how long I'm going to be stuck in here? By the time I get out, she won't even know who I am. Oh, that's why Brenda agreed to it, isn't it?
Calm down, Lace.
Well, it's the truth, isn't it? She's going to end up with her in the end anyway.
Chrissie, look, just trust me, will you?
Trust you? She's your wife. Now, look, Del. I want Elizabeth away from her. She's not having my daughter.
Chrissie, please.
I'd rather see her adopted out. You can tell her that from me.
Well, look, that's just bloody stupid.
You just tell her, Del.
Well, that's enough.
You tell her.
Wait outside, will you?
You make sure you tell her, Del.
Lighten down.
Del.
You go out of your way, don't you, to ruin everything you touch. Okay, Latham, that's your business, but my business is when you start getting noisy about it. Now just calm down and shut up, will you?
We made a bomb. A bloody bomb. Did you hear that? Those Perth blokes will be back for more soon. We could work out a few extra tricks and screw them for 500. What do you say to that? Don't bother. You haven't finished work. I said you haven't finished work.
I've finished.
Get undressed.
I've got a deal for you, Des. You can keep the bankroll. I just want $200. Enough to get a train and get a long way away from you.
And what do you think will happen?
I'm not frightened of you anymore. I've been locked away most of my life. Well, first my aunt and uncle locked me away, and then the police locked me away. And now it's you. Well, I used to escape because I didn't have any rights. But now I've got rights and I'm just walking out.
You cheap little tramp. You're walking nowhere, sweetheart. I spent too much time breaking you in.
Breaking me in? You don't break people in, you break horses in.
Shut up.
You break people down, Des, like you did to Donna. You break them down with dirt and dope. I need $200.
Oh, I was wrong about you. You're dumb, really dumb. Just like Donna. Dumb, stupid bitch! I'll fix you, you bitch! Get out of there! The trouble with you is you don't know what you want. You didn't want to go on the beach, sweetheart. Then I had to show you how easy it was. Now you don't want to try smack. Well, perhaps you're wrong about that, too.
No! No! No!
Let's find out. Hey?
No! No! No!
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around,